Amendment lawyer Hollie Manheimer. Hollie served for many years as the executive director of one of the sponsors tonight, the Georgia First Amendment Foundation, and she is now a DeKalb Magistrate Judge.
Somebody who deals with people on a daily basis on very low-level disputes. Fourth lens I looked at fake news from was the idea of being a citizen, how we perceive it. But the most interesting thing I think I can tell you, the lens that has the most interest, I have practiced law for a number of decades with politicians. So I have a lifelong practice of law with politicians. And really watching them and looking at this idea of fake news through that lens was what I think I learned the most and might have the most to say today. So let me go back and try to answer your questions. Number one, what do I diagnose as the problem? And number two, what can I suggest as any solution? As the director of the First Amendment Foundation, my job, as I mentioned, was to talk about open records and access to find out information. And I see fake news embodying this idea. All of us have touched on it in some way. Nobody's really that interested in truth, or maybe a small portion of the population is. But from coming from the perspective where my job was to dig and help people find truth, I'm seeing really a departure from an interest in the truth. From my lens as a lawyer, a lot of folks would say, there are a lot of lawyers here that were not that interested in truth. But certainly, we were interested in finding the facts, and one of our jobs was to look for the facts. And what I see, and all lawyers I think would agree with me, is we've become very adversarial, and in some ways, we're less interested in finding our facts well, and we perhaps skew too much, and certainly more than we have done. As a judge, my job is to find the truth. I got to get to the bottom of the dispute. And again, that echoes what all the other things I see. It's hard to get at the truth that people don't present properly. And in my low-level courtroom disputes with people yelling at one another, it's really hard to find out what the truth is. As a citizen, I can't find the truth anymore. It's this idea that I don't know how to find it. I want to find it. And again, this fake news concept prevents me. I don't know, and I suspect many of us in this room feel the same way. But let me go to my fifth perspective, practicing law with politicians for many years. I'll never forget this. I sat down with one of my law partners a number of years ago. I won't identify who it is. He or she said to me, "You know what politics is about?" And I said, "No." I said, "I don't. The art of self-promotion." And I never thought the number one job of politicians is to self-promote. And I never really thought of that until recently, because that's what we see across the political spectrum. And my dear friend is sitting in the back, Jerry Weber. We used to, I wasn't as big of an Obama fan as he was, but my point is, politics is the art of self-promotion. And that seems to me inconsistent with all the other things I raised. The first four categories were interested in truth. Politicians less so interested in truth, and I think that's the genesis, or some of the genesis, of fake news. So I'll be brief, because we want questions. So solutions. From my role as the First Amendment Foundation Director, I say, keep using your open work records law, keep pushing for transparency, keep trying to dig the facts up yourself, because we might not be able, at least for the short term, and I hope you're right, I hope it gets better, but we might not be able to count on news right now. From my role as a lawyer, all I can say is be professional, professionalism, courtesy. In my role as a judge, what I'm trying right now, for example, in my animal control cases where I get a million of the same neighbors coming in asking me to solve their problems all the time about barking dogs, I'm sending them to mediation to work it out themselves in my order. So I'm saying some self-help, which kind of echoes the idea of what I'm suggesting the first in my role as a First Amendment Foundation. Let's see, what was next? As a citizen, thank you. I'm just gonna try to read more, try to dig more, try to use my open record skills and just keep asking the same questions that all of us are asking here today. But lastly, I would say for the politicians, the self-promoters, if I can be so bold, I think we just gotta do a better job of electing measured individuals, thoughtful individuals, and folks who do not promote this context of fake news. Thank you.
Thank you.